love, life, and marriage.
Woohoo!
Now, I am sharing the platform with my two amazing, phenomenal, wonderful co-hosts, K. Rich and A. Fox.
Hey. Hi!
Thank you, ladies. And I also wanted to bring something new to the table for you for our premiere show. If you were paying attention, if you were listening, you could not have missed the wonderful sounds of these two gentlemen who were on the Angela Foxworth show. They came on, they rocked the house, and they brought R&B gospel at its finest. Please help me welcome to our panel to help give us the male perspective of what makes a hot wife. Split Image.
You're going to give a real male perspective. Y'all better be ready. The real.
Ladies and gentlemen, y'all heard that the real perspective,
right? It's going
to
be the battle of the sexes tonight.
Okay,
right?
I'm loving it.
Well, we're not going to waste any time. Let's go ahead and delve into the topic of what makes a hot wife. I'm going to kick it off and say that for me, I think that what makes a hot wife and what makes a hot woman, period, is a woman who knows her worth.
Amen. Mm.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, I believe that if a woman knows that she's fearfully and wonderfully made, when she knows that we were so good that God had to put a man to sleep in order for him to bring us into fruition.
So when
that's going to be a song.
That makes you a hot. That makes you hot, period.
That is a good one. What
y'all think about that?
I love it.
Okay.
Well, I like it, but like they say, what they say? Woman in the streets. And a freak in the sheets. I'm going to just be real with you. I know this is AM radio, FM radio, but we ain't going to.
We're going to keep it right.
Yeah, I mean,
and you just being honest from a male perspective, that is what they're looking for.
A woman who, will compliment you.
Amen.
I mean, they're very respectful in public and holds it down at home. Not just in the bed, holds the house down. No, it's a difference between the women you see all on the internet and everything. Amen. When a man is choosing a wife, a hot wife, that's why you always see them single. When you're looking for a real woman, because I don't see these big stars, when you actually see their wife, what? She look plain Jane.
Right.
It's a difference between a trophy wife.
That's right.
And a real woman.
That's right.
A real woman has that entire package. You know what I mean? Looks, take care of home, and will raise kids. That's what a man looks for. That's a real hot wife.
Right, that's a hot woman.
Looks ain't everything. Looks is superficial.
Amen.
That lasts.
That's right.
Lord bless you to live long enough, all that goes away.
Amen.
So they can have them bang in shape. Yeah, that's good. Give it time. All that go away.
I love it.
Whatever she got.
Amen.
That's what I look at.
So what else she got?
Yeah.
Exactly.
We can close up now. Really?
Seriously.
I think my definition of a real woman that a man looks for, you're looking for a wife. He's looking for a companion. When God said he created you a helpmeet. Mm-hmm. And what he mean by helpmeet, a lot of men get confused. A lot of these women out here think that just because they make a lot of money, they up on the stratosphere like everything, that they don't need a man. Mm-hmm. But in actuality, you do. And a man would love to have one of those type of women. But I've been married for 10 years now.
Amen.
10 years. But keep in mind, the one thing I like about my wife is that being married, we complement each other to the point that it doesn't matter about how much money I make, how much money she make. It's all in the same account. So you get a wave, good. We got a rain.
Amen. Amen.
So when she buy, we got a new car, we got a new car. It doesn't matter where the money is coming in, because it's all going to the same place, going to the same bank account, and we spend it on our kids, and we spend it on what we have to do. Mm-hmm. So I don't get caught up in titles, and she support me, she compliment me, and I compliment her. I think that's what the most important thing about it.
Awesome.
Because behind every strong man is a strong woman.
Bam! You better say it.
Strong sister!
You better say it.
So let me ask you a question with that. So when you met your wife, when you saw your wife, did you know? Because they say you know when
no.
you see.
No.
He did. He did.
Well, hey, I'm just being real. I saw that shape.
Right.
That's what I saw first.
Yeah, I think that's what you
all. You know what I mean? And it was like, it was on from there. You know what I mean? We got to know each other. And over time, yeah, you will. You did. After like 6-7 months to a year.
We knew. That's the one.
We set it on down. You know. Yeah, they said, yeah, you know.
But, you know, men are very visual, so,
this is true.
You know, you have to really take into consideration. It has to be somebody who's attractive to you, whatever that is.
Yeah.
You know, and I think for a lot of women, we get caught up in what society says is the perfect
woman. Yeah.
You know, but when you think about it, there's somebody for everybody.
Yeah, I say that all the time.
There's somebody for everybody.
Somebody
it doesn't really make
everybody.
A difference what kind of shape you have or what kind of hairstyle you have, if it's natural, if it's, you know, wigs, weave, whatever. You know, at the end of the day, there's somebody out there looking for
let me say this.
You just as
size
you are.
Size doesn't matter. It's confidence. Men look for confidence. Now, you see some girls, you be like, how she get a man? And then you see some girls, you be like, why she ain't got a man?
Yep.
Exactly.
Right? So, yeah, confidence is everything. And how you carry yourself, what you got up here, what you carrying in your heart. Like they said, it's more to the package than the outside look. So get out of that mind frame, that size and how she get a man. She got one. You know what I'm saying? So that's important.
Personality. Yeah. Because I seen some pretty women out there with a nasty
attitude.
Make them seem like ugly women.
Right.
If you got a good attitude, you know how you got a good personality, you can get out there. Because I learned a long time ago, if you want to be, if you want to get friends, be friendly. You want love, show love.
That's right. That's
and
right.
I guarantee you attract.
That is so true.
Exactly.
That's right.
So it does boil down to substance, is what I call all of that when it comes to a woman. It's so funny because you talk about being plus size. You know, that's not the, you know, norm or whatever that goes against what society views as beautiful, you know, in a sense. But you will go to places, you know, sometimes with your spouse, especially if you have a good-looking spouse. You know, this visually stunning to everybody. And what I found is that they will look, especially bad women, to the bone, dressed in the nines, hair all flawless and this and that. But the funny thing is that man is looking for substance. I used to do a little contest. Me and my girlfriends, we would all go out. And I always been the plus size girl. But they used to call the plus size girl the purse holder. She was the one that would hold the purses for all the pretty women. Well, what was funny, so, you know, of course, they try to designate me as the purse holder. Whatever.
Oh, my purse girl.
Right. But what would be funny is we go to the club, and I already knew what would happen. We would get in the club, and I knew the guys would be like, oh, I'm going to buy drinks for everybody. So, of course, by default, I'm going to get my drink. You know, I'm cool back. Something to fall back on. You know, when I want to talk to my husband, and he's into sports, and if I don't know anything about that, I don't have any interest that we can have outside of just being married, there's nothing left. I mean, you can't live off of sex alone. I'm sorry. It's good.
That's true.
And we
That's
love
true.
Having it. But after a while, it gets to be monotonous after a while if you don't have anything to back that up. So I think that's
right.
What's real important.
I agree.
Yeah. Definitely, definitely.
But sex is important, people.
It is.
Sex is important.
Absolutely.
It is.
Absolutely.
Well, I'm going to tell you guys. So I went on this website, right, called goodguyswag.com, right?
Okay.
Because
okay.
they actually had the wife list. Ooh. And they talked about the 10 things that they feel like make a hot wife.
Oh,
so
okay.
I thought that'd be very appropriate.
Right, right.
And
okay.
we can interject. So, you know, I don't know. Do we want to take a break right now before we delve into this, you know, amazing subject? Because you'll be surprised what men love.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back to talk about the 10 things that Guy Swag says make a hot wife. And we're going to continue this topic about what makes a hot wife. We'll be right back. We're on Praise 108, 108praiseradio.com.
Very good.
All right. Good job. Guys,
that was hot. Yes. So good.
So what's the list?
Right back to talk about the 10 things that Guy Swag says make a hot wife.
And we're going to continue this topic about what makes a hot wife. We'll be right back. We're on Praise 108. 108praiseradio.com.
Got it.
I can play some praise song.
Keep it.
Hey, you gotta mix it up.
She forgot her song. That's what it was.
She's guest on it.
Praise.com. And so before the break, A Fox says she found an article by Guy Swag, is it?
Yes, it is Good Guy Swag.
Good Guy Swag. And it lists 10.
Yes,
defies
10 things,
hot wives,
yes,
that make women hot.
That's
and
right.
So A Love came out with her list. So we're going to do the battle of the lists and see
And A Love, what's the title of your list? Because hers is different. It's about what makes a sexy wife,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, mine is 10 Rules of Being a Sexy Woman. This was in Huffington
sexy
Post.
Okay, right. So let's see if the men get it right.
Okay, so we're actually going to break down the first three of each list. So I'm A Fox, and this is my list. Number one, she shares your beliefs. So they talk about when it comes to finding your wife, I've heard equally yoked. We're going to expound on that. Number two, she makes you a better man.
Come on now.
Boom. Okay. If every day is hell with her, that should be a red flag. So talk about potential. We're going to expound on that. And number three, she's trustworthy.
Come on now.
That's right. She has to be like Proverbs 31. You have to trust her with your heart. Period. So those are the first three, and that's of God Swag. So go ahead, take it away, A-Love.
All right, this is A-Love coming to you with the 10 rules. We're going to start off with three of being a sexy woman. Number one is you carry yourself like a lady. The words woman and classy should remain synonymous.
That's right.
Number two, you stand on your own feet. So that means you bring something to the table.
That's right.
Besides your appetite. And number three, you don't throw yourself at anyone. You carry yourself, as they say, like a lady.
Amen. All right. All right. So now we'll expound on those. So we'll expound on our number one first. How important do you feel like women should be as they share your beliefs? How important is that for you in a marriage?
That's very important.
Exactly.
I mean, it goes hand in hand together. Amen. We have to share the same belief. I mean, like being unequally yoked, that can actually drive a relationship apart.
Right.
I mean, no disrespect. If you have like totally different religions, I'm a Muslim and you're a Christian.
Right. Yes.
How's that going to work?
Yeah.
I mean, I love me some pork every now and then. You know what I'm saying? You say, I can't eat no pork chops or something. You know what I'm saying? I say, hey, baby, get in the kitchen and cook me some pork chops and eggs. I can't get none. Cause, you know what I mean?
Okay.
I think it's very important because one, like Barbara said, a man is the head of the household, so he sets the thermostat in the house.
I like that.
The man sets the thermostat. Hey. It's the woman who try to make sure the temperature is just right, but I set the thermostat. So if my woman supports me and I'm leading the house because God is the head of a house and he made the man ruler over the house, controlling and managing, the way you want to call it.
Uh-huh.
So I make sure that my spouse that I bring on shares my same admiration. Amen. If I'm trying to go down a certain road, we can close for us.
Wow.
You know, they love our stuff so bad, they're out there passing out CDs and everything for us.
That's awesome.
All right, now.
Before you go on, A-Fox, let me ask the question. What can y'all explain the difference in when they say that opposites attract in comparison to being equally yoked?
That's a good one. You know, opposites do attract because, not me, but some men like them crazy. Some about a crazy woman, like, man, you know what?
No.
Her craziness dry. Oh, I like that. She cuckoo.
Now, let me ask you this. Is it more that she's cuckoo or challenging? What I think when you ask a question like that is that, you know, when you talk about being unequally yoked, it's like, it's kind of like reminds me of people when you flock together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you may have differences in different ways that you get to a certain point, but you all have the same vision of what you're trying to get to.
Right.
Marriage to me is the exact same thing.
Mm-hmm.
When you're unequally yoked and you have two different beliefs, period, it's going to negate the differences that you bring to, you know, in household, because you can have a man or a woman that's turned up and their husband or spouse who's very laid back.
Exactly.
That is the attractive, but their vision of going together is what makes them, you know, is
absolutely
what brings that to a full circle, you know, so to speak.
Well,
and that
know,
is
that's
real
my,
important.
That's my thing. You know, I always say I don't believe opposite attract. I don't believe opposite attract. I think familiar spirits attract each other.
Mm-hmm.
And so even though it appears that they're opposite, you understand, like you said, one may be turned up, one may be low-key, there are commonalities there that attract each other. The familiar spirits attract each other. It's not the opposites that attract each other. He want a crazy woman because there's some crazy there. You got me? Okay,
not
some crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy makes me.
I want a crazy woman.
Crazy is lying dormant. You're crazy there.
Sad.
You know what I'm saying? So,
please believe
that you know, I'm real low-key. I'm real low-key. I don't do drama.
don't do
so I ain't attracting drama in my life from friends, from mates, from, you know, I don't attract drama. And if I see it coming, I'm going the other way. So that's how I know that the opposite ain't what I'm looking for. You understand what I'm saying?
That.
It's just, it operates different. It looks
like
different.
That.
And so what happens is we think it's opposite attract. Ain't no opposite attract because you wouldn't recognize it. Or you would recognize it so much, you're going to run the other way. You understand what I'm saying? So I think that like matter attracts each other.
All right. All right. I like that.
Good job.
So,
high five.
And
high five.
A love with regards to, okay, so I did my number one. You do yours. Expound on that one.
Okay, so number one was you carry yourself like a lady. Mm-hmm.
Like a lady.
They said
it says, at all times, no exceptions. So, you know, and they went in to reference how, you know, sometimes you can go out to the club, you know, and you see women who are drunk. That's unattractive.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
And you need to understand that even when you're in different places, somebody's always watching. And you never know, just because you may be single at a given point in time, God may be preparing that man. He may be in that place and happen to see you.
Wow.
And based on how you carry yourself in any given circumstances, may be the difference of you and him hooking up and eventually going down that pathway of marriage, or you just being somebody that they're going to play with for a minute, and then they're going to move on to somebody else.
That's true.
That's true. That's good.
Yeah.
I like that.
I like that. You could definitely nail that, buddy.
Like a lady. Shanae.
Hey. Okay, so the number two, of course, on Good Guy Swag was she makes you a better man.
Mm.
Now, I love this. This is so rich to me because I feel like, just like you said, behind every successful man is a great woman. I just think that when a woman supports the man, it definitely raises their level of confidence. If they have things set in place at the house and they are believing together, they both want to do something financially and they're, you know, birthing each other's dreams. I think to have that strong, solid, you know, just a ride or die right there in the house with you, going through the things that you're going through. When you're tired, they have things in place that'll make you feel good and be relaxed, where you look forward to coming home. You know, good meals cooked sometimes. It's not always just that, but you do stuff because you want to do it and because you love them, not necessarily because you feel obligated. One of the things that I find most challenging, especially in an industry that you guys are in, whether it be gospel music or whether it be secular music, temptation is temptation.
Right.
And it hits you when you're in the industry a lot harder than it does. So let me tell you what I find so strange. When you have a woman who's so envious and just so insecure to where you're just stressed and you can't even find, you know, a way to get to, you don't even want to go home because you know you're going to hear foolishness, you know, for no reason. But if you have someone that truly believes in you and wants you to succeed and trusts you, a lot of times when a woman trusts the man and makes them feel secure, they won't do anything wrong because they would never want to do anything to harm that.
Yes.
But when you're getting beat down every day and you're said, oh, you're doing this, you're doing that, and you have someone that just does not have your back, a lot of times in your mind you be like, I'm going through this foolishness anyway, so I might as well, you know, do what I gotta do. So what do y'all feel about that?
Man, I think that's, you hit it right on the nail. I think a man needs that support at the house because that way, a man does not want to cheat. A real man
Amen.
Don't want
right.
to cheat on his wife.
Right.
That's the reason why, like my pastor broke it down one day. A man should not leave home drunk.
Mm-hmm.
When he broke it down, he should get all his drinking at home.
Amen.
If he go out, a woman should not let her man go out in public thirsty. So if I get all my drinking at home, I don't need nothing else when
like
I get out.
I like that.
Men are simple.
We are simple creatures.
Y'all
really
are. We're simple.
Yeah.
If you take care of your man
yeah.
like a woman's supposed to take care of her man, I guarantee you.
Boom.
He'll do everything you want.
Amen.
He'll be eating out your hand. I'm telling you. If a woman understood her place
and stroke his ego with
me. I'm just serious.
Rub
I'm
his head.
A man's ego.
Rub his head and rub his back. A little piece of mind, as my friend said, a little piece of mind and a piece of tail. That's all me and want. Piece of mind and a piece of tail.
Amen.
And they good.
I'm about to say they like stroking anyway. You get it. Okay.
I mean, so.
We be stroking.
Stroking.
All right. We're not going there.
I mean, stroking the ego. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, but a man like his ego stroke as well, because if a woman gives her man affirmation all the time, and then command, you don't know, if we have all the burdens on our shoulders, mm-hmm. we handle everything, yeah. and a man got to come home to argue. The Bible said, it's better that a man sleep on top of a roof than come home to a nagging wife. Mm-hmm. So, if he's always coming home to that, and he's not getting that attaboy at home, but he's getting it from somewhere else, that would make a man be like, you know what, I'm better off in the streets. If I'm getting all this, I'm in the streets, you do, let's say for instance, I do art. Mm-hmm. And I go out and everybody give me all praise about how good your art is, how good this is. Yes. And I come home, I'm getting no attaboy from my wife. And she's like, oh, that man, I don't care about that none you doing.
Like,
really?
Yes.
I ain't got no strength. This girl is telling me how good my stuff is.
Mm-hmm. You beat me and Mrs. Jones. And we got a thing going on.
And that's what makes a man be like, you know what?
That's right.
But when he finds a good woman,
amen.
A real man is not going to, he's not a good, not a good, but good woman. He's not going to risk a piece of tail.
That's right. That's right.
And mess up a whole house.
What he got? Amen. I love it.
I know for a fact. I'm like, look, she look good.
Yeah.
But is it worth me losing everything?
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. That's right. That's right. I love it. So, Angela, what's your number two?
My number two is you stand on your own feet.
Oh.
Mm.
And basically what they're referring to is that, you know, back in the day, it was really prevalent because, you know, the man was the breadwinner and the woman was the homemaker. But now that society has changed, mm-hmm. you know, more women are in the workforce, more women, you know, are fully, you know, full careers or entrepreneurs, you know, they're trying to do it all.
Yeah.
And so the thing about it is, even though a woman may depend on the man for the financial support or vice versa, at the end of the day, you want to be able to know that your woman's bringing something to the table. Like you said, she's a helpmeet. She's being able to help bring something to the household.
Yeah.
And if something were to happen, what if, you know, for whatever reason, God forbid, you got sick.
Mm-hmm.
You want to know she can handle it. You
Amen.
Don't want somebody who, you
Amen.
Know, don't know where the water bill is, don't know how much you pay
right.
for a mortgage, don't know how to go out and handle business. You want somebody who can take care of things, whether you're in a position to do so or not.
That's right.
And this is a real rich topic, actually, too, because we talk about, you know, men and women in submission. Okay,
right.
So to me, this goes in line with that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then there are two perspectives
perspectives
of that, because, of course, I get beat up for what I'm going to say. Lude, I want to be taken care of, okay? I'm tired of working. Tired of working hard. You know, in my mentality, when I was a single mom, dude, I want somebody to come rescue me, okay?
That's all.
But look, the reason I say that, not that I don't bring anything to the table, but in my mind, as I was raising what I want, because I think everything is a preference, I would like for the man to be the one that I just have, you know, to lean on him. He's a visionary, so he knows how to, you know, articulate how this household is going to be. And I'm his G back there in the back helping make it all happen. You know, and that's what I've always...
You know, are fully, you know, full careers or entrepreneurs, you know, they're trying to do it all.
Yeah.
And so the thing about it is, even though a woman may depend on the man for the financial support or vice versa, at the end of the day, you want to be able to know that your woman's bringing something to the table. Like you said, she's a helpmeet. She's being able to help bring something to the household.
Yeah.
And if something were to happen, what if, you know, for whatever reason, God forbid, you got sick.
Mm-hmm.
You want to know she can handle it. You
Amen.
Don't want somebody who, you
Amen.
Know, don't know where the water bill is, don't know how much you pay
right.
for a mortgage, don't know how to go out and handle business. You want somebody who can take care of things, whether you're in a position to do so or not.
And this is a real rich topic, actually, too, because we talk about, you know, men and women in submission. So to me, this goes in line with that. Okay, so then there are two perspectives of that, because, of course, I get beat up for what I'm going to say. Lude, I want to be taken care of, okay? I'm tired of working. Tired of working hard. You know, in my mentality, when I was a single mom, dude, I want somebody to come rescue me, okay?
That's all.
But look, the reason I say that, not that I don't bring anything to the table, but in my mind, as I was raising what I want, because I think everything is a preference, I would like for the man to be the one that I just have, you know, to lean on him. He's a visionary, so he knows how to, you know, articulate how this household is going to be. And I'm his G back there in the back helping make it all happen. you know, to, and that's what I've always.
And she take it. Care of her, my mom, they come and they take care of their husband and let the husband know you could be a janitor. It doesn't matter. If you're a janitor,
that's
and
right.
you doing
that's
what
right.
you got to do to take care of your house.
Hard
you
work is hard work.
Hard work is hard
Amen.
Work.
And
you,
Amen.
A lot of women, I notice, look over the hard-working man
that
because
they do.
Made a big career and everything. They single all their life.
Oh, you're they
56
do. 56
yes. years old, and you still single, but you don't pass up a good man who would love you.
That's right. That's right.
And, look, and looking at.
Well, that's a whole nother show,
though.
Too. Yeah. That's a whole nother show.
Oh, yeah, we're going to expound
I'm
on it. That's
you.
What this show
yeah.
is all about.
Right.
But you're absolutely right. And they, you know, do turn their nose up at people who do work hard. And those are your diamonds in the rough
mm-hmm.
that you don't even have mm-hmm. no idea.
Exactly.
Don't ever despise humble beginnings.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell young ladies that all the time because you never know. See, I know the difference between somebody who's telling her she need to make the money and somebody who's really trying to do it himself. There may be a gentleman that doesn't have a car, but if he's saving and has a good vision for what he's trying to do, there's something to look forward to. But if he just happy about you just footing the bill and he don't have aspirations to do anything, no, you should love yourself more, especially single moms too, you know, because that plays a role. That's another show altogether.
Yeah, that's definitely.
Right.
I mean, it's just so many. You said so many dynamics there. I mean, what
is
a good man? What is a good man? That's one thing. How do you even define that today? You know what I'm saying? Number two, who is God? I mean, a lot of people don't even know God the way we were raised to know God. You understand what I'm saying? So that's not being introduced in a lot of homes to a lot of young people the way we were introduced. That's two. Number three, I mean, it's just so many dynamics to that thing. You have a lot of young ladies whose self-esteem is so low, so they're going to take whatever they can get to say, I got a man. You got a lot of women who too high and mighty, so independent that they're not going to accept anything, but they so lonely. You understand what I'm saying? But,
yes.
you know, so it's just so many dynamics to that. That can go 100 ways.
Yes. And we are going to tackle those.
And I guess somebody here was saying that, you know, who is teaching a husband or a wife to be a husband and wife anymore? You know?
Oh, and that's
yeah.
real. And that's real.
That. You know,
Amen.
From our Hot Wife, Hot Life ambassador, Monica G. Brown.
Woohoo, Monica!
You know, and it's so important when you think about it because for so long we had grandmothers.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
You know,
yes.
And we had people who could teach you
yes.
and, you know, show you. You had a representation of what it means to be in a husband and wife relationship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, but then as people start having children younger,
yes.
you know, you start getting away with what a real grandmother, you know, you don't even want to be a grandmother now. You just want to be a G-mom or, you know, you want to be
yeah.
something else outside of that. So when you start getting all those dynamics coming in, now
okay.
you don't have those conversations. Now you just go out there and you just figure it out yourself.
Yeah.
You know, and it makes a big difference. Now you're not even having conversations.
Yeah.
I like you, you like
yeah.
me. We
yeah.
get together. Once you start having sex, before you know it, boom,
mm-hmm.
you got a
baby.
Before you know it, boom, if you get
yes.
married, if you get married, if you're not shacking.
Yes.
But if you get married, you haven't even had the conversations you need to have.
Yes.
To be able
so
to determine
true.
If this is a person that I want to spend my life with.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because a lot of times you don't know until after you've already got married. For those that do, go ahead
right.
and make that decision. A lot of times you're basing it on what you feel like is the right thing, or it could be pressure from your parents, or whatever the case may be. Then you get in a relationship and be like, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Because there's so many things that you need to know about people. Let me just go ahead and help somebody out real quick. Get over the fantasy, boo, because marriage is very beautiful.
It is
an awesome concept. There is romance. There is beauty in it. But for everyday living, it is
hard
work, okay?
Definitely.
So when you have this unrealistic expectation that y'all going to be on Pegasus in the beach, usually that lasts the first 6 months.
Yep.
When you got to actually get down and start
I don't even think
it
lasts 6 months anymore.
Look, I was trying to help. Look, I was trying to help the young people out there. Y'all might get 6 months out of it.
I didn't think they get it 6 months.
The reality is, a lot of times you think people will change once you get married.
That's
you
it.
Do.
That's
yeah.
it. That's it.
That's
what
you
do.
Like, yeah, you
I'm
think,
so
okay,
glad
when
you said that,
Ayla. He's going to change. No, he's not. Whatever.
Yeah.
A person
or,
is,
I can change
or I can change
him. Yeah,
him.
I can change
yeah.
him.
But
I
at
can
the end
that.
Of the day, however a person
mm.
is when you're with them before you say I do,
yeah.
if anything, it's going to
yeah.
get worse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very rarely will it get better.
But okay, so Keeba, we've discussed this before in the past, right? That is such a, you know, fine line in that area
it
because
is.
As you grow and evolve,
right.
I mean, change is inevitable.
That's right.
In
correct.
Anything.
Yes, it is.
How do you?
Or it should
how
be.
Do you, right. So how do you do that? Because we've talked about this, where you have one spouse that wants to stay status quo, everything the same, and then you have this other spouse that just wants to go for the gusto.
Well, usually in a marriage, it is a visionary and it's a stable person.
Okay.
Okay. It usually is that. Like you said, you are the visionary. You know what I'm saying? You're the go-getter. I'm the go-getter. You're the go-getter. My husband is real low-key. He don't want to go. He's the same person every day. He's going to go the same way to work. He's just boring. And it's okay. And you know what I'm saying?
Was it boring when you're married?
It was. But I'm going to tell you this. It
he
was.
He go 285, never want to go 20.
It was. It was boring when I married him, but I was in a different place.
Yes,
and it's
so
what I needed.
Me.
No, it's what I needed. Yeah. I needed stability, and he provided that for me. Okay? So as I grew and he stayed the same, it bothered me.
Yeah.
Okay? And I was getting upset and all antsy because I'm ready for him to get up and go with me. And I had to realize happiness is a choice. Happiness is your choice. Can't nobody make you happy.
Amen.
You make yourself happy. So when I stopped trying to change him and get him to be like me, instead of accepting him for who he was already, and that was good enough in the beginning, then I learned to be okay. Now I'm good. I'll be like, boo, I'll be back. I'm traveling around this world. I got you some souvenirs, and I'm coming back home. You know what I'm saying? And he's good with that.
Amen.
But you have to be okay with yourself first. It starts with you. If you're not good, then it ain't gonna be good.
Amen.
And you can't make them do anything. They already a person, already got their, they may never change.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They may never go any further up. They may stay, that's good. Because something did attract you and make you go there with them in the beginning. Remember that.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
So.
All right. I love it. I love it. Okay, so number three. And I know we're winding
down.
Mean, listen, when you having fun, listen, you're
going to
have
to keep these going, you know, throughout the weeks, huh?
Yes. You know what I'm saying? She's trustworthy.
I like it.
How important is it for a man to
man,
trust
it's really
woman?
Important to be trusted. Listen to me now. Listen
did
to
I
me.
Strike a card? I
struck
you.
A chord now. Because keep in mind, men and women speaks on two different
yes,
levels.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Women think, when you say, do you trust me, a woman thinks of fidelity. Mm-hmm. Infidelity and
right.
stuff like
mm-hmm.
that. Yeah, yeah, I trust. But a man thinks about it totally different.
Yes.
A man thinks, when I say, do you trust me, I need you to trust me. A man is saying, when I tell you something in a time of weakness, will you use that against me? If I'm down,
I
I'm telling you something. I'm going through some stuff. If I'm going through some stuff, and I tell you, then when you get mad, that time you talk about this, you're like, oh. You're going to go tell me, you told my brother. Everybody looking at me like, yeah, I heard about it. When you broke down that day, you got fired. And men from that point would be like,
right.
really?
That's
okay,
that
I know how much I can trust
wow.
you.
Wow.
And that's,
I can't trust me. I know men. I tell you, if I can't trust you, it'd be crazy. That means a man will start withholding his feelings
mm-hmm.
from you.
And
he'll
then,
tell you what you
want
to hear, but
wow.
he's never going to tell you what's really going on inside because last time I did that you would have told
right
your mom.
You know what? Now, that was great. That's ladies,
yes.
I hope you were
yeah,
listening
yes,
to that
yes,
right
yes,
there.
Yes,
it's
yes,
something
yes.
you need to pay attention to because
yes.
I firmly believe that a man will always let you know how to handle them. They leave you clues. They leave you, you know, for women, we have to make sure we pay attention.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Because something just that simple, a woman thinking, oh, okay, well, I'm going to just tell her, you know, it's no big deal.
Yeah.
Not realizing you even broke that trust.
Yes.
And once you break that trust
yes.
for a woman, we may be like, okay, well, we'll take it back. Okay, I'll forgive you. Boo, let's move on.
Yes.
For a man, it's hard for y'all to get past that. Like, you like, you broke my trust one time. I don't know if I can, girl, I don't know if I can get back with you on that same level. We might still be together, but you broke that trust.
Yeah, you won't talk about everything.
Yes. Well, let's flip it, okay? Homeboys. Well, y'all be popping off at the homeboy talking about how agitated she is. You understand?
I love it.
look, then what'd you say? You said, boop, boop, boop.
Well,
like, oh, that's how you rolling. That's what you want to tell your homeboy about. But you ain't tell me I had no attitude.
Well, because men ain't going to tell you, we ain't going to hurt your feelings, you know?
Okay, but is it important for you to communicate exactly what it is you have an issue with?
Yes and no.
Okay.
Because been married long enough sometime. My mama told me, you ain't got nothing good to say, don't say nothing at all. If I tell my wife something that's really going to hurt her feelings, mm-hmm. I'm not going to say it.
Okay.
Because woman, how do I look in the dress? Like, girl,
right.
But you know what was so funny? Like, my husband is totally, no lie. He was like, but where's you going? Now, look, doesn't mean I'm always gonna, if I like it, I like it. Mm-hmm. So you just deal with it. You married to me, sit down somewhere.
Okay.
But,
oh, let me tell you why I lie with coming handy. Though. When my wife was pregnant. Mm-hmm. She always thought, yeah. Look at me, I'm bald, yeah. Big, and my yeah. Face got no. I'm like, baby, you still look good. Mm-hmm. I'm like, girl, you do like a house.
You know she listening, right? I'm just saying, you gotta go home tonight. That's all. I'm just saying.
But
that,
no, I got what you're saying. But you gotta let her know you still got something.
It's a gift.
Is like that a lie?
No, it's just like you true. Said, like stroking your ego, yeah. You got to stroke her at that true. Time. Yeah. You got to know when
keep it 100, Big yeah. Steve. Keep it going, Stevie. Father God, best don't be a shot at you.
My wife, I love my wife Coca-Cola by her. She's real fine.
Well, I'm a two-liter
she
bottle,
always
but Steve.
Saying,
he's a two-liter.
She always right, worrying about later. How she looks. Women always
well, that's women.
Look.
That's a woman.
True.
Thing.
You look good. You look true.
That's a woman thing, though.
But you got to say, too, I think it's also demographic. Let's just keep it 100. In Atlanta, where you around all these peaches, a lot of people do peach, say that peach. The temptation level goes up in cities, especially when you 23 chicks, you know, to one dude. Mm. So, of
Won't
course, your...
Look at God. Look at God.
I'm telling y'all, what y'all tell you, we can't go home, y'all can't go home, y'all gonna be in trouble.
Party, get the studio room ready, get the studio room ready, y'all gonna be in trouble. But with that being said, you know what I'm saying, like, that's why I think a lot of women too here, you know, they just want to make sure they're on point. Because they do want to look good for their husband or whatever the case may be.
I just think it's women. I think it's all women. Yeah. I think that's just what we do.
They got issues.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? I think that's just our makeup. It's just something about us. We always pulling, checking, looking,
well, yeah.
Scared, you know.
Well, you know, for us plus
good,
size people, we got
to
keep things pulling. You know, contend to ride up a little bit. You know?
Don't,
don't
let
be putting them goodies out in the street.
Somebody for everybody.
Yeah,
I totally
it is. Amen.
Yeah.
Well, awesome. Listen, ooh, we wow. Have come to the conclusion of Hot Wife Hotline. Listen, I know,
amen,
audience, I know y'all
Lord,
said y'all
Lord.
Need 3 more hours. We got you. We got you. Listen, we're going to continue to break this down each and every week. Just
it.
Tune in every Monday night. You're part of Monday Domination from 9 p.m. Eastern Time to 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time. You come right here in the studio for a party. We are going to get some marriages saved. We're going to get
yes.
Some single women married.
Yes.
We're going to get some husbands to finally find the wife that they want. Mm. This is what this movement is all about because
that's
it is
right.
A movement. So let them know how they can get in touch with us. Say love.
You can reach us on Facebook under Hot Wife Hot Life, on Instagram and Twitter _ Hot Life Hot Wife. And... email info@hotwife-hotlife.com.
Sorry. So each and every week, 108 Praise Radio. Listen, you guys, split image.
Thank
we
you.
We got to give it up to y'all.
Y'all got the mail. Y'all kept it
great. I want to tell y'all wives right now, you guys have two amazing husbands. We were so glad to have them in here prior to the show. They could not wait to do you guys proud. So listen, let them sleep in the bed tonight.
Yes. ATL.
All right, so you have heard it from A Love, K Rich, and me, A Fox. And you guys have an absolutely wonderful week. Tune in next week, same time, same place.
Yes.
Hot Wife, Hot Wife. Good night.
Woo! You good?
Don't be. You talk now.
We're out. Yeah, that was good, that was.
Yes, that was good.